Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to edit an audio file in GarageBand. So I'm using GarageBand version 10 here. We're going to look at just editing a simple file. Here I've got an audio file from somewhere else and I want to just edit it down. I want to take some things away, maybe filter it. So to do this in GarageBand, we're going to create a very simple project. We'll just start off with an empty project here. We'll choose it. It's going to force us to choose an instrument here to begin with. So it doesn't really matter. We'll just say microphone and it'll create the project for us. Now the next thing we want to do is we want to drag and drop this file into GarageBand. And we're going to do that by dragging it to another track here. And you can see it's added it here as a second track. Now that's the second track, we can select the first one and use Command Delete to get rid of it. And then we'll take this track and drag it over so it starts at the very beginning there. And we'll also get rid of the library here on the left, and we can just see now this track of audio just laid right in there as track one. So we have it in GarageBand. We could actually export it right now and we could save it also as a GarageBand project right now, which is a good idea to do before we start. Now we can easily preview what's going on here in the audio file. We can position the playhead anywhere we want and press play and listen to things there. We can also trim it out. So if we decide like somewhere in the audio we want it to actually trim everything from the beginning here. There are many different ways to do that. One way is to split up the song into different sections. So we'll do that. We'll select it here and we'll split regions of playhead, and there we go. We've got these two separate areas here, and we could simply delete this one if we want and move this over here to the beginning. I'm going to undo all that and undo the split there. So another thing we want to do is probably we want to filter this maybe in some way. So let's bring back the library here on the left, and we've got all of our filters in here. So we can filter for voice and select a filter for something else. So we can maybe make this into a bright vocal here, and we can further edit the controls by clicking on that button there and then going in here using the equalizer. And we can, as we're doing this, we can listen in or to bits and pieces as things change. So we can even get fancy if we want and add other tracks. So if we, for instance, wanted to add a musical loop to this, we could select a loop in here and add something. You can even add some sound effects, like say this is actually a talk I gave, so I could drop in some applause at some point or some audience background if I wanted to enhance what's going on there. So you can add other tracks to it. You can trim it. We can cut out pieces of it if we wanted to. And we can play with the quality of it using different filters. And then when we're done, we could simply share it out. We can export it to disk or send it to iTunes and share out the new version of this song or speech or whatever the recording is. Now you can even use this technique to take music from your library. I'm going to click on that in there and then go to audio, and I can select iTunes music, and I can see the songs in my iTunes library. I can drag those songs into tracks here in GarageBand, and then I could go ahead and edit those as well, or add those as backgrounds. So, you know, copyright issues notwithstanding, you do have the ability to take that music and to use it in GarageBand and edit it in GarageBand.